students, this is Professor Sagar Birje, and I welcome you all for the online class of analog and digital electronics. So in this video, we are going to discuss on the next technique of minimizing the Boolean expression, that is the Quinn-Maclossy method, or we also call it as a tabular method for simplifying the Boolean expression. So what exactly is Quinn-Maclossy method? How we are going to use this Quinn-Maclossy method in simplifying the Boolean expression? That is what we are going to see in this introductory class of Quinn-Maclossy minimization technique. Okay, so in my previous class, you must have seen the different minimizing techniques for Boolean expression. The first one was your Boolean algebra, where we applied all the Boolean theorems in simplifying the Boolean expression. The second method was your K-map technique, which is a graphical method of simplifying the Boolean expression. So every method was different means of simplifying the expression. Now we have a Quinn-Maclossy method. Every method that we use, whether it was a Boolean algebra or it was a K-map, every method had one or the other drawback. So let us understand what exactly is Quinn-Maclossy method and how we are going to use this method in simplifying the Boolean expression, and what are the steps that we are following in order to simplifying the Boolean expression. That is what we are going to see in this particular class. So let us understand the introduction to Quinn-Maclossy minimization technique. So the K-map method of simplification is convenient as long as the number of variables do not exceed 5 or 6. As the number of variables increases, it is difficult to make judgment about which combination forms the minimum expression. Another important point is that the K-map simplification is manual technique, and simplification process is heavily dependent on the human ability. To meet this need, W.V. Quinn and E.J. Maclossy developed an exact tabular method to simplify the Boolean expression. So this method is called as the Quinn-Maclossy or the tabular method. So the fundamental principle of the Quinn-Maclossy method is that the mean term whose binary equivalent differ only in one place. Remember, the mean term whose binary equivalent differ only in one place can be combined to reduce the mean terms. Okay, so let us understand the algorithm for generating the prime implicants. So what are prime implicants? What are essential prime implicants? What are implicants? You have already understood in my previous video. If you have not watched my previous video, kindly go through these concepts. So these concepts of implicants, prime implicants and essential prime implicants are going to be very much helpful for you in understanding the concepts in the Quinn-Maclossy method. Okay, so let me start with the algorithm for generating the prime implicants. So the first step in this process of generating prime implicant using Quinn-Maclossy method is that we are going to list all the mean terms in a binary form. So whatever mean terms that are given in the Boolean function, we are going to represent those mean terms in a binary form. Okay, so if we have a mean term 8, so we are going to represent this mean term 8 as 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, if we have a mean term 4, we are going to represent as 0, 1, 0, 0. If we take another mean term as 5, we are going to represent it as 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay. So hope you remember the binary representation of these decimal numbers. Okay, here we, as they are a part of this function, we term them as a mean terms. Okay, so after listing all the mean terms in the binary form, what is the next step? In the next step, we are going to arrange the mean terms according to the number of ones. So the number of ones that are occurring in the binary representation of those mean terms, we are going to categorize them or we are going to group them. Suppose 0, 0, 0, suppose we are representing a decimal number 0. The binary representation of 0 is what? 0, 0, 0, 0. So there are no ones. We are going to categorize it. So So the next one, suppose the mean term is 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1. So there is a single 1 present. If the binary representation of 2 is what? 0, 0, 1, 0. So there is a single 1 present there. 8, 1, 0, 0, 0. So there is a single 1 present there. But if you go to the representation of 5, so how it is? 0, 1, 0, 1. 6, 0, 1, 1, 0. So if you look in the binary representation of number 5 or 6, we have how many ones? 2 ones. Similarly, there are other decimal numbers whose binary representation will be having more than 2 ones. So we are going to categorize these numbers according to the occurrences of 1 in those binary numbers. Okay, this is what the step number 2 talks about. Arrange the mean terms according to the number of ones. The third step is, which is a very important step, kindly focus on this particular step. Compare each binary number with every term in the adjacent next higher category. What I said? Compare each binary number with every term in the adjacent next higher category. And if they differ only by one position, underline this, if they differ only by one position, put a check mark. Put a check mark and copy the term in the next column with an underscore in the position that they differ. So this step number 3 is very, very important. Apart from representing the mean terms in the binary form, arranging the mean terms according to the number of ones, the third step plays an important role. We are going to compare each binary number with every term in the adjacent next higher category. And if they differ by one position, put a check mark and copy that term in the next column with an underscore in the position that they differ. Hope you have understood this step number 3. Step number 4 is apply the same process described in step number 3. Once again, we need to repeat the same process that I have mentioned in step number 3. For the resultant column and continue these cycles until a single pass through yields no further elimination of literals. So this process has to be continued. This process of finding the mean terms which differ by one position and putting a check mark and putting an underscore where the mean term or binary number differs by one position, this process has to be repeated. Okay, and then in step number 5, we are going to list all the prime implicants. We are going to list all the prime implicants. And after listing of prime implicants, in step number 6, we are going to select the minimum number of prime implicants which must cover all the mean terms. So after listing of all the prime implicants, then the final step will be to select the minimum number of prime implicants which must cover all the mean terms. Okay, so it may happen that there might be some terms, remaining terms, and all the terms that did not have check mark during the process are also called as the prime implicants. Okay, so the remaining terms and all the terms that did not mark during the process are called as the prime implicant. So summing one or more prime implicants gives the simplified Boolean expression. So summing one or more prime implicants gives the simplified Boolean expression. So this is all about the algorithm that we are going to use for generating the prime implicants for using Quinn-McCloskey method for minimizing the Boolean function. So once you have understood this algorithm properly, you can apply this algorithm in simplifying the expression to find out the minimum terms which are going to be a part of my final Boolean expression. Okay, so in my next video, you are going to see how I apply this algorithm steps to simplify the expression using Quinn-McCloskey method with different examples. Okay, hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt or any queries regarding any of the steps that we have just now discussed, you can kindly text me I will be there to solve your queries. Thank you, and keep on watching my next video on the Quinn-McCloskey method of minimizing of Boolean expression with different examples. Thank you.